What's up, guys? This is Mike. We're going to show you some cooking today, and we're going to do some legs at Bev's. Come with us. Make sure it's set on zero. And then obviously the plate weighs something. So reset it to zero. And then we'll get like 2 8-ounce meals out of this. This is a pound, so usually about half would be 8 ounces off the bat. Oh. See, that's eight and a half. So for about half of that, 8:15, 8 ounces, boom. And then what I do with the turkey, the turkey's pretty lean, but I'll do with that, I'll just season it with this. So I get some Trader Joe's. It's just sea salt, garlic, onions, and parsley. Put that on there. And then with my turkey, I make burgers out of it. Makes it easy. Tastes good, and then I can put it on the grill. Everything on the grill is better. Everything, way better than a pan. And when you're dieting, better the food tastes. Makes it alright. A lot of people complain about dieting because the food doesn't taste good, but you can make it taste. You can definitely make it taste decent. So as we saw, that was about 8. So 7. 7.8, I mean, it's pretty close. I mean, what are you gonna do? And then again, just make a little burger out of it.
AC?
I'm gonna be outside now. Cause I got a drill.
Got that thing smelling good already, man.
Alright, so we got chicken, beef, chicken and turkey burgers, all about 8 ounces. And then this is a beef burger, 8 ounces, and you got 2 4-ounce beef burgers, so 8 ounces in total. And then right here we got 8 ounces of red potato, same seasoning on there. Throw that in here. See, you could. A lot of people say they don't have time to cook, but that may have took not even 10 minutes. And then we'll throw this on for 30, the grill for 30. So altogether, less than an hour a day. You can eat your food fresh every day. You gotta eat anyway, right?
Right.
You put that on there. You could do, I mean, I'm kind of a lazy cooker. So you could go like every 2 to 3 minutes and flip. I'll just do like 5, 5, 5.
beef cooks up faster than the white meat, because you can eat the beef a little bit red if you want. The white meat, you just want to be safe. That's why I like to cook every day, because then you don't have to worry about food going bad and spoiling. Just take the time. Wake up early if you have to.
So I'll take like the extra meat that I left over, just because I don't like to, obviously you don't want to waste food. And I eat chicken or turkey with my eggs for breakfast. So I'll just save it and then it adds up. Because I usually eat about 6 or 8 ounces of that with breakfast anyway. So I got another fridge here in the garage. This is like pretty much like keep like the storage stuff, like the Sam's Club, Costco type buy and stuff. So we got plenty, obviously plenty of eggs. We need our eggs. Then we got the actual liquid egg whites for the lazy like me. I got coconut water, diet soda. Got the, I eat whole eggs, brown whole eggs. So like for the white eggs, you could egg whites, but the whole eggs are for the brown stuff, for the whole eggs. And then we just get our my monsters. I don't really take pre-workout, so that's good for that. Use Gatorade, and then obviously tons of water. That's just not much water.
This is what they want to know right here.
Hey,
this is what they want to know. What the fuck is he taking?
I'm candy. All right, so this is what I do during my training. It's called intro workout. So I set the scale to grams, because grams are obviously lighter than ounces. 28 grams in 1 ounce. So this is citrulline malate. Put that in there. See, a lot of supplement companies, they make supplements, right? And you guys get really excited about them, but they're all underdosed. So you get these pre-workouts and all these supplements, and I use 10 grams of citrulline malate. I see supplements with 1, 2, 3 grams. Not effective dosage. So what I do, I buy them separately, individually, and that's how I do them. These are amino acids. Go 20 grams here.
For the record, that's probably the brown stuff y'all see in the water bottles.
Yeah. the toilet water. This is hydrolyzed casein protein, which is it's like a fast digesting protein. And then highly branched cyclin dextrin, which is a carbohydrate, a super fast absorbable carbohydrate. And we use 50 grams of that. So as you see, I measure everything out too. I don't set, the scooper will be like, oh, well, this is how much is in a scoop. No, everything needs to be pretty precise. Then I take 20 ounces of Gatorade, add that to it, and then fill the rest of the water, and I just sip on that while I train.
That's Mike's secret stuff.
I try to add water to it, like, obviously being hydrated is important, so
right.
Just keep adding water as much as you can to it as you sip. Everything is in here. So, as obviously, you have your performance supplements that you guys sew with the intro workout stuff. Then you have your health supplements. You wanna make sure everything inside is functioning. So you're gonna get your micronutrients from supplements or vegetables, right? So things like salad, like string beans, broccoli, kale, spinach. These have vitamins, vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin K, vitamin D. Mm-hmm. And then to make sure that you're getting enough, I do things like the vitamin C, ubiquinol, resveratrol, vitamin D. Vitamin D is super important because we live up east, right? I mean up north, on the east side, and we don't get that much sun during like the fall and the winter. So, and then omega-3 fish oils. Omega-3, we don't really need 6 and 9 as much as people think. 3 is like the healthiest one. So, heart health, and then micronutrients. Take that stuff in the morning. And then I take a multivitamin as well. Yeah. That's over there.
Okay.
Alright, so I got like these little things like that make your food taste good when you're dieting, right? So like fat-free cheese, reduced sugar ketchup, 75 less sugar. So look, I got right ketchup here and reduced. People don't realize like little things matter. So in 1 tablespoon of this is 1 carb, right? Or 1 gram of sugar. Whereas in 1 tablespoon of this is 5 carbs or 5 grams of sugar. So you're saving yourself 4 carbs for the same size. Food still tastes good. It's just you're not getting as many calories, right?
Yeah.
So you do what you gotta do to make the food taste good. That, and then I'm like, I love my Cholula hot sauce. This is no calories, nothing, it's just sodium. And then mustard, no calories, stuff like that. I mean, I stay stocked on that stuff. And then stuff like this. I don't really know how good this is. This is like Walden Farm stuff. It's like a pancake syrup and it has 0 calories. I don't know how they make stuff like this. I get kind of freaked out because it tastes too good for what it is. But if I eat it, I'll put a little bit. So this is for you, but when I make my burgers, I don't eat the bun. You'll see mine, I have a burger with my potatoes, but what I'll do is I'll take the fat-free cheese, put it on there, and then what you could also do, what I do, is a lot of people like pickles, right?
Me too.
Oh, okay, you too. So, instead of a pickle, cucumber, right?
Same thing.
Yeah, but better, right?
Yep.
So, do you want cucumber?
Yeah.
Okay. Your food tastes good, no excuses, guys. No excuses.
And we're gonna cut for this meal. We're gonna cut.